sail out onto the sea. Through your eyes into eternity. Got one life and find out what it's like to feel this one high that is true. Supernatural. What am I always running from? Well, I'm not running anymore. Not running.
We've reached a crucial stage in the great shift that's unfolding all around us. The old paradigm is unwinding, passing through an inflection point into the new paradigm. It's going to affect every single one of us in our relationships, in how we live, our very physicality. And it's crucial that we inquire into exactly what is going on. The purpose of this documentary is to illuminate a perspective on where we feel within the Open Hand team, what is going on right now, what's taking place, and how can you best ride the shift, ride the changes that are coming so as to thrive through this tremendous opportunity which is unfolding before us. That's what paradigm shift is all about.
Well, there's definitely a palpable energy that you can feel on the planet that something is brewing. I mean, you know, from Ireland to America, there seems to be a feeling in the air that something big is brewing with the planet.
We've reached a crucial stage in the shift, which is the inflection point. The unwinding of the old reality from the previous construct, the previous paradigm, and into the new. And that's impacting everything. And Gaia, who's underpinning that, she is moving with it too. She is inspiring the shift. And it's crucial that we understand exactly what is going on, because it's going to impact every single one of us in our relationships, in our careers, in our general living circumstances. It's going to affect us physically, emotionally, mentally, karmically, and it's going to work to unfold who we really are. So it's crucial to understand it and what is taking place. The wholesale exploitation, destruction of the planet has reached pandemic proportions. From the pollution and toxification of the earth and the oceans and the sky, to accelerating and abrupt climate change. And the pandemic mistreatment of sentient life within the industrial food chain, with 65 billion grazing creatures slaughtered year on year. And that is creating tremendous suffering. And sentient beings the world over, and of course Gaia too, who underpins this reality, can feel it. And so there's this increasing urge to unwind the old paradigm and begin to unleash the energy into the new. At the same time that this is all happening, there is this incredible emergence of soul within people everywhere. We're connecting to the divine by aligning, attuning with the soul within, feeling our interconnectivity with the whole of life, following the flow, the signs, and the synchronicity, connecting with Mother Nature, sentient life. So people everywhere, in all walks of life, are feeling it inside of them and beginning to connect to the divine and yearning for a higher harmony, a higher connection, a higher vibration. That's what we're yearning for, to respect life, to be in harmony with life, to align with the natural flow, the deeper meaning, the real purpose of why we're here. And so the expansion, the unfolding, is happening out of the breakdown of the old paradigm. But many people are still stuck in the old consciousness, interrelated with it, conditioned by it. People around us, people that we know, friends, family, work colleagues, they're connected still into the old reality. And they will be feeling fear, anxiety, resistance to moving forwards. They'll be concentrating, focusing upon survival and what that really means for them. And they'll get emotional and they'll want to bring you in, into that experience, into that anxiety. And it's important that we understand the impact that they're likely to be feeling, and us too, so that we can support and help, yes, but at the same time, we can only give what we have ourselves. And therefore, we must be able to embody the light no matter what is taking place around us. We need to be able to do that. Because when you embody and shine the light, then others will feel that steadying energy, that reflection that reminds them something about who they really are too. Ultimately, we're going to be shown mirror upon mirror in this shift, in this phase, which is inquiring, asking, who are you in relation to all of this? It's where you get to decide that you are not merely physical, that you are not just a physical being. All realities come and go. No moment stays exactly the same. We are shifting consistently in a universe of constant change. Change is the only constant, and we need to be able to embrace that. We need to be able to embrace change as the driver of our lives, to innovate, to keep unfolding, to keep expanding, to decide who we are in relation to this, that we are spiritual beings, that we are cosmic beings, that we are children of the universe, not just one limited reality. And so the shift is going to reveal that to us. And it's an invitation for us all, a golden opportunity to step into all that we can be, to unleash profound beingness of soul and to set it free within the world and to express who we really are. That's the great opportunity that is unfolding before us. And we need to understand it, embrace it, turn into it, so that we can succeed, so that we will be resilient, so that we will thrive in what is taking place. That's the opportunity that exists for us. And so this documentary is designed to explore the different aspects that are impacting us right now, so that you can be inspired to become all that you can be. This awareness, this understanding, this knowing, it is being embodied from enlightened masters of the ages who are, if you like, an integrated energy, a higher dimensional presence, which is gathering here around the earth with other sentient beings from different constellations, from the Pleiades, from Arcturus, from Andromeda, from Sirius, from all around us who are gathering, and also the angelic realm, of course, who are gathering to build a bridge into the higher paradigm of consciousness. And how are they working? They are working to remind us of who we truly are. To me, a truly benevolent being does not tell you your reality. They share a perspective, their perspective, which we're sharing in this film. It's not to tell you this is the truth. It is our truth. It is what is felt within and felt to express. But you must process it through your own heart and mind and discover what is true for you. What do you resonate with? What can you feel inside and what strikes a resonance with you? And if you don't resonate, then let it go. But my invitation is to maintain an open mind and an open heart so that you can constantly explore what is unveiling, unraveling for you. Quite often, we'll look at reality through veils, and we might not like what is going on. We might be afraid or anxious, and we might feel that is tightening inside. And it's essential to be aware of that too. So if I tighten in some kind of anxiety, then there's a golden opportunity for me to unfold, unwind, to become as one with this. Because by becoming as one, you explode the myth of one's fear within it, one's anxiety. You explode the myth of that. So this documentary is designed to illuminate, to share a perspective, to activate a resonance at this crucial phase. We must not sleepwalk forwards into the future. We must become as one by exploring the truth of what is going on. And the truth will truly set us free.
It's her time to raise her voice and to let us know what's going on. And often, I would say before this more awakened state, people would walk around thinking how beautiful it is, or isn't that lovely? And you go visit, you tour over here to see this part of Gaia, not know it was just a place to go. And now she's like, no, let me show you a little bit of my personality. What is this? Well, here I'm going to show you how powerful I am here, and let me show you what I can do over here.
So what exactly is going on in this paradigm shift? The Earth has suffered an interdimensional intervention of what we might call an opposing consciousness, acting through the field which has affected, influenced the hearts and minds of the vast majority on the planet. You can see this in the wholesale exploitation, the destruction of the environment, the mistreatment of sentient life. Since the start of the Industrial Revolution alone, merely 200 years, on a planet that is 4.6 billion years old, humanity, society, has cut down 50% of the trees and obliterated 50% of the wildlife. That is unconscionable almost, that has taken place. And yet it has, and yet it's real. At this current time, 200 species of creature are moving on every day. As the Hopi said, the Hopi elders, we're in a great cleansing, a great unwinding of the reality itself. And we can see, we can intuit, we can feel, and what is being given from the dimensions that I'm certainly picking up is that we're now in an irreversible event line that will see a progressive breakdown within the biosphere that we're living within. And at the same time, so this is a dramatic crucible of experience, and at the same time, people are emerging out of that. So it's crucial to understand, to feel, to intuit the impact of what is going on so that you can equalize within it, which means to become as one with it, so you can unwind, unfold through it. So this intervention has taken place. It is all around us, but the shift that is going on now, this new phase, this unwinding of the karmic construct, that is the means by which this cancer that has stricken the earth to be unwind, to be unfolded, to be cleansed, so that a new emergence, a new paradigm can happen. So don't expect that as the new paradigm emerges, that it's going to be all rosy, because it's not. Just take a look around at what you're seeing. Embrace what you're seeing, because then you won't be impacted so strongly by what transpires, either in the bigger picture or in your own life. So this is essentially what's happened and what's brought us to the point where transition change is absolutely fundamentally necessary. Sentient life is suffering here, the balance, the majority, and there is this collective yearning to ascend and move on. That's what's truly taking place in my understanding, my feelings, and what I'm intuiting right now.
The hooking in of the other being, the hooking in into my energetic field and sucking in that energy, feeding off from that energy, is actually for me kind of a signpost. It's kind of a necessary process, so that if I open up to it and I don't condemn it, and I don't blame it or blame the other beings, then it becomes an opportunity for me to really notice very clearly, because it's so intense, notice very clearly where my blind spots are.
Contemplate this for a moment. We live on a small planet, in a small solar system, a galaxy which is teeming with solar systems, a universe teeming with galaxies, a universe of 11 dimensions. So with this in mind, I ask you, is it more crazy to think that there is sophisticated life force out there, or that there isn't? It's a moot point. When you look at the megaliths that exist around the world, it is clear that they were not built, that early civilization was not founded or constructed from primitive tools and primitive cultures. Take a look at the Great Pyramids. The idea that hordes of slaves chipped out rocks with basic tools and hauled them up planks into place is faintly ridiculous. The Great Pyramid is aligned perfectly with north, south, west, east. It contains the mathematical figure of pi, the speed of light. When you measure the ratio of the circumference of the base to its height, it's exactly the same ratio as the circumference of the Earth to the height from the center to the North Pole. The three pyramids are exactly aligned as Orion's belt, as it was in the night sky in 10450 BC, when the constellation was at its lowest in what's termed the precession of the equinoxes. It's clear that a highly advanced civilization helped shape not just those structures, but the entirety of civilization itself. The evidence is abundantly clear. If they did exist, the question is, where did they go? What I would put to you is that they never went away, that they exist in the field all around us, and have shaped humanity and society from its very early beginnings. The evidence is not only in the megaliths and structures around the world. When you look inside our very physicality, you will see that certain adaptations, certain hybridizations have been made. The average human has 4,000 or 5,000 genetic disorders, for example, when the average creature less than 100. We have 223 genes that appear nowhere else on Earth's tree of life. We're supposed to evolve stepwise through natural selection from the hominids, who all have 48 chromosomes. Why do we only have 46? When shifting from 48 to 46 is a natural disadvantage to evolution, and is also not one single step change, but several that happened all simultaneously. The scientific evidence is abundant, and yet for me the most compelling are past life regressions which people across the planet are now sharing, who are recalling what went on hundreds, thousands, and even millions of years ago. People are recalling that transformations, hybridizations, enslavement happened. People are recalling these things. What is the purpose? What is the agenda here? Well, it's in my direct knowing, having connected with many of these different groups, that, for example, on Sirius, when it went through its ascension, 120 million years ago, that was traumatic. It shattered the civilization. And many were cast adrift, disconnected from the natural flow and the cycle of reincarnation, who felt abandoned by God, if you like. That's the terminology. Who were advanced, very developed in controlling, manipulating the field from which physicality is shaped itself. And they began to travel through different constellations, from Sirius to Orion, and into this constellation, till they ultimately came to Earth. And their agenda has been to recreate the civilization that they lost. And one of the what they really need to do, their key agenda, is to be able to incarnate and embody. And the way they're doing that is to change the very frequency of this vehicle and the surrounding planet. What that means is that you can infuse soul that way, because this vehicle has to be able to receive that frequency, that vibration. Now, what's happening to people is you're getting streams of different consciousness come in and different messages. You're getting one message, one stream of consciousness, which is control, manipulation, trying to adapt, change the environment to fit your personal needs, and that includes other sentient life. That stream of consciousness is coming in, and you can see it by the trace that it's leaving, by the destruction that's happening across our Earth. There is that stream of consciousness. But the thing is, because it's coming in through mind, body, emotional body, the karmic field, it feels like it's a part of your own consciousness. It's not until you get deep within and start to unravel, unpick the various influences that are going on. It's not until you do that that you start to experience, well, there's the impulses and the natural aligned frequencies of your own soul and that of the misaligned intervention. It's when you start to see that different patterning. What it reminds me of is when Christopher Columbus arrived in the West Indies, that the population couldn't see him arriving, couldn't see the ships because they had no frame of reference. It's very similar. Humanity has no frame of reference for this interdimensional consciousness that's going on out there. It wasn't until one of the shamans saw the bow waves of the ships, the trace that they left, that the ships came into view. And then he was able to help the other members of the tribes to see the ships landing. So it is with this interdimensional energy. You see it first by the trace it leaves within you. And then as you start to unravel the patterning, then you start to see, know, intuit, and feel this intervention going on. The question is, how do we best deal with it? Well, the first point is to work internally. And that way, it doesn't matter if you're skeptical. It doesn't matter if you don't believe even that this is happening. Maintain an open mind, but work inside of yourself. Accept it as the manifestation of your own shadow side. And then as you work with that, you can peel it away and you can eject, you can push out that intervention. So the first point is to work within yourself. And as you start to discover the intervention, it's also essential that you don't judge, that you don't demonize or polarize, because this only creates identity, us and them. That creates and perpetuates struggle and fighting inside of yourself if you're not careful. The point is to realize that it can only be there because it's a reflection, a manifestation of humanity's own subconsciousness. That's what's created the karmic reality and is holding it together. So not to judge, not to polarize, not to demonize. Forgiveness, yes, that's also essential. But not weakness either. To be really clear in your own field what serves you, and the embodiment, sovereignty of your own soul, and that nothing else is allowed to persist within your field. Be really clear inside of yourself and unravel and wind that which is embedded itself within. Not to judge, work internally, and then crucially, humanity and star souls too that have come from across the constellations and understand this energy all too well. We're come here to help that energy, to bring it back into the universal fold, to reconnect it with the cycle of reincarnation and to realign it back to its home consciousness of Sirius, of Orion, of Draco, all of which you see within the Great Pyramids, depicted within them. So our role, our purpose, is to help realign them. And that is a fundamental part of the paradigm shift that is going on. This energy does not belong on Earth. It is not of the commensurate frequency of the Earth and of this vehicle. So realignment is necessary, and that is going to progressively happen as the 4D layer is peeled off the Earth and life here reconstituted, realigned to what it is meant to be. So dealing with the intervention inside of ourselves and supporting the realignment is a crucial part of the paradigm shift.
I'm an earth soul, and as an earth soul, I just revel in the beauty of Gaia.
I think Gaia is reclaiming herself, going back to where she wants to be, and will share great abundance with those who appreciate.
My glimpses into the 5D shown me a magnificence and a perfection that is on an even greater level, that's so, so mind-blowing to the human heart.
So how is Gaia responding to all of this? How is she dealing with this intervention that has happened, the destruction of the environment, the excessive exploitation? Well, to feel that, to understand that, we must go deep into the heart, deep into our feelings, and connect with nature. And I believe when we do that, she will speak to us.
Long for. Om Tara Tutara.
joyous and gentle, wild and free. Simple in her majesty, dancing in the unity we long for.
To me, what she's revealing, expressing, is a tremendous level of compassion and understanding. She has formed the foundation of the karmic construct in which we're living. She embraces the fact that we have karmic lessons to explore and unfold through. For example, how can you be in the physical, the dense physical, the beautiful physical, how can you be in that and at the same time be connected to the divine? How can you be in both places simultaneously? And that's a great challenge when you have such extraordinary multiplicity of form. How can we co-create in harmony with all life? So not just honor our own interests, but those of other sentient beings around us too. How can we co-create in harmony? How can we respect all life? These are some of the explorations that have formed the very bedrock, the blueprint of this karmic construct which we have all agreed to in order to be here. And she understands that. She accepts that. She has her own karma to explore through. And yet, despite that compassion and despite that incredible awareness, it's clear now that the shift must begin to unravel, unfold, and accelerate. Back in 2012, at the time of the galactic alignment, many people around the world prophesied, expected, hoped for a dramatic change in the environment, but on one day, that was never going to happen. The environment, the shift into a new paradigm was never going to happen on one day. And yet there was great truth at that time that was shared. And to me, the truth of what took place was revealed to us, was shown to us at the time of the Summer Olympics in 2012, when in the Olympic Stadium itself, the organizers, they had intuited that must have been some divine connection which intuited the opening ceremony, because they built a construction, a model of the Glastonbury Tor in the center of the stadium. Now the Glastonbury Tor represents the heart chakra of the planet through which transformation, transition will happen. And during the ceremony, we saw how the Industrial Revolution obliterated the landscape, the environment in which we were living. It metaphored that so beautifully, so accurately. And then through this decimation, toward the end, we see the hoisting of 5 golden rings above the stadium. The 5 golden rings to us symbolized, to us at Openhand at least, symbolized the shift through 5 expansions of consciousness into the 5th density. And I believe, I'm given, I feel it is affirmed by the signs and synchronicity that that ceremony signified to the world, even if people don't immediately see it and pick it up, it signified to the world in front of billions of people exactly what is taking place here, what's going on. And then at the crucial galactic alignment on the 21st of December, many sentients around the world felt like Gaia was giving birth. She was giving birth to the new paradigm in the fifth density. That's what we experienced. It didn't all take place on one day. It had been happening for some 20 years or so leading up to that point. But we very much felt that was the completion of the shift of her center of consciousness into the fifth density, the birthing of the new paradigm. So that's what took place around that crucial shift of 2012. Since that point, if you really step back and contemplate it, the Earth has gone through a dramatic acceleration within society. Huge challenges to the environment, acceleration of climate change, increasing global warming, the release of CO2 into the atmosphere, and the acceleration of unfolding of sentient beings, of souls, awakening souls around the planet. The shift has been dramatic in just a short space of time. And now it feels very clearly like we've stepped into a new phase, a new chapter of the shift. And we could call that unwinding the karmic construct. That is where the blueprint, the threads of consciousness, which form the 3D reality. So the blueprint is in the 4D, the karmic construct, the 4D. That's the blueprint. That starts to unwind. Why? Because the sentient being, the deva, in this case Gaia, underpinning it, feels, discerns that in the interests of all sentient life, the balance of sentient life, it is time to start unwinding that so as to create the opportunity to open the doorways for the shift of more consciousness, the withdrawal of energy into, through the fourth density, through, it's like passing through across the Red Sea, the parting of the waves into the higher paradigm. That's the phase that has now begun. That's what I'm given to feel, to understand, that is reflected in signs and synchronicity. And to me, the Kilauea volcano that has recently erupted, and many volcanoes and earthquakes around the world are signifying this. Why is this happening? How is this taking place? What's causing it right now? Well, we're in the crucial stage of a pole shift. Now, usually, pole shifts take thousands of years to complete, but recently, Berkeley scientists from California have confirmed that the current pole shift is likely to complete within the space of one human lifetime. Now that is really important that we hoist that on board and work with that. Work to understand what the impact is going to be, because we can see that from the geological records from the past when it's happened previously. It unleashes not only earthquake volcanic activity, but dramatic storms, which will transform the surface progressively. Now, crucially, this is not going to happen overnight. It's begun now, but we have a window of opening. It's a few decades where we have time to transform in this. Now, you could see this as something negative. You could be afraid and fearful of it. But you can also look at it from the other side of the coin, that dramatic change presents incredible mirrors, mirrors that are internal reflections that activate blockages, tightness, trauma, karma. We are here to process karma. And as it's confronted to us, as we feel it arising, we get the opportunity to become as one with it, work into it, and expand out. It's in these crucial moments where you get to really feel and experience yourself as a sentient being, as a cosmic being, one of the universe. You know, from the moment you were born, all of us, we're destined to die, to pass on into another existence. We have been here many, many times before. And you're watching this, if you're watching this, at some level, you know that. And so if there's tightness, the invitation is to soften into that and unwind through it. So there is the opportunity where reality transforms slowly over thousands of years. The mirrors aren't so strong. You can kind of walk along happily, almost sleepwalk along that transition. But we are witnessing now a dramatic acceleration. So the mirrors come very strong, and there is the opportunity. We have created a crucible of profound alchemical change, and within that lies the opportunity for the forging of the soul, the emergence of authentic beingness, to know ourselves as true spiritual beings, interconnected with life. We have a golden opportunity to experience spiritual mastery.
Shift actually is accelerating, as I think.
I think the shift is empowering and exciting.
More and more people getting awake, like getting out of the matrix with their mind.
This work helps me mend me, and then I am empowered to help others.
The old way of being, actually, everything transmutes. The old will fall apart, fall away, actually. You really have to feel through. I feel through, like, what is the right thing to do for me? If I do the right thing, what my heart wants to do, I accelerate the shift.
the change we all need, because it's time.
So how can we respond to the shift, this dramatic transformation that is happening all around us? Well, first and foremost, we must embrace the truth, because only the truth can truly set us free. If you are distanced from what is going on, if you are ignoring what is going on or in denial of it, then you create this polarity internally, where you're a kind of observer identity connected to the old paradigm. And so that polarity can be victimized, thrown around by the swirl, the movement of energies happening through the field. The only way to transition this truly effectively and to thrive in it is to become as one with it. It's like riding a surfboard. If you are trying to think about how to navigate through the shifts and the movements and the water, you will be behind the wave. But if you are on the board feeling the nuances of movement within you, then you become as one with the wave. And that's the crucial thing. And you can only become as one with it if you are not in denial. So when you feel something, when you see something, observe, witness, it's important to explore it, to honor the truth of it, and turn right into it. That's essential. Because then what you do is you narrow the distance to it, which means that you equalize with it. You normalize physically, emotionally, mentally, and then ultimately karmically within the changes, the transformations, the flows that are taking place. So to confront the truth is first and foremost. And that is really not necessarily someone else's truth, but how you feel in relation to what is going on. But also being open to changes and how your perception might shift according to what might then take place around you. Secondly, we must learn to not only tune into the soul, but to listen and follow it. How do we do that? Well, tuning in is really tuning into the sense of rightness of the soul. When you feel completely authentic, real, and in your groove, so to speak, when everything seems to be kind of clicking in around you, and your expression, no matter how it's being perceived in the outer, where your expression feels like it simply flows, then you know you're coming from soul. And when you're in that vibration, when you're in that feeling and that flow, then signs and synchronicity are going to click in to affirm that you are in the flow. So even if somebody else outside of you, in the mirror if you like, takes umbrage about your expression or reacts negatively or it fires off something in them, look also further afield, and if you perceive sign synchronicity, if you feel, yes, no, this is an authentic expression of me, then you know you're coming into the mainstream of soul. Now, there are a myriad of ways of connecting up. Meditation, of course. Not just meditation, though. Self-inquiry. The inquiry, who am I being in relation to my life, in my relationships, in my career, in my living circumstances? Who am I being in relation to that? What buttons get pushed? Where do I get tight? It's about owning what I manifest, what you manifest, as your creation, that you draw everything to yourself for a purpose, for a reason, for a lesson, that you are the creator, the manifester of your reality. And to own, embrace that, because that's the ultimate empowerment. When you embrace what you create, you have the capacity to change. If we are continually blaming somebody else for what they've done to us, that gives them the power, not us. You manifest, you create, you draw to you. And it churns something up, it activates something, and it offers the potential to see one's own resistance, attachment, karma. And then we can start to work through it. So meditation, self-inquiry, deep consciousness body work like Tai Chi, yoga, for example, connecting with nature and other sentient life, animals, flowers, the sky, the trees, the grass, whatever it is that really makes you feel connected, that connects you up. So Mother Nature is a great way of connecting in, but also creativity, the creative arts, like painting, like music, like writing, blogging, vlogging, all of these things, the creative expression touches a deep aspect of soul. And so that's going to help us activate different aspects, elements of soul too. And then it's about following the flow, allowing that to take you, to guide you to whatever experiences you need to have. Where is it going to lead you? So this is the next part. We need to develop strong spiritual practices and processes for getting into tightness, source pain, karma. Karma is often the subtle vibration. It begins with subtle vibrations underneath the level of the emotions and the mind, underneath the level of identity. The first aspect to this, the crucial part of it, is not to plaster over our feelings with some false gloss of everything's good, rosy, love and light, because it's not. And if we approach every moment with that kind of strategy, then what we do is suppress what's underneath. Likewise, if we distract through entertainment, distraction with mobile phones or the internet for this kind of thing, if we distract, we're not going to get into those subtle vibrations and feelings which spark off karma. Let's be clear. Humanity has gone through aeons of challenges, lifetimes of war, of conflict, of suffering, as well as the great side of being incarnated. We've experienced all of this, and people will be carrying this around in the causal body in the fourth density. And that begins often just as a little thread of experience, a vibration, and if you pull on that by paying attention to it, it's going to fire off. And it's important that it does. If you have not gone through years of wave upon wave of karma activating that you have to process, likelihood is you've not yet processed your karma. So it's important to get into that, or else we won't be able to ascend into fifth density consciousness. The shift, the ascension, is like the rise of a hot air balloon inside of you. And as it rises, it pulls on karmic tethering, and that's what activates inside. And so that's what we must confront. How do we confront it? You must become as one with it, which means to express it, to work into it, to honor it. You let the expression of it come into your life. It kind of expands out into a reality, and you get reactions from people around you, from the various circumstances that are going on in life around you, and it fires things off inside. At that point, we must get into those feelings, honor, express them, become the one in them by becoming as one with the experiences. It's like passing through the eye of a needle again and again and again. And as you come through, it's like you contract internally into it. You start to identify with this reality. And that's the opportunity to equalize, to normalize in it, to be so accepting of it that you don't even need it to go away. Let's be clear. You are the one. We all are the one. And therefore, everything is moving within us, both the shadow side and the light side. And we must be equally comfortable with the all of it to be the one. And so We pass through the eye of the needle, we equalize in it. At the point we're so accepting that we don't need it to go away, that's the point that you've become the one in it. That you know you're in that incredible place of acceptance and surrender, that incredible place of empowerment. And as you're in that empowerment of complete acceptance, something is going to arise. Something new. In that moment, you are reclaiming lost fragments of soul gold that got buried in that sediment, in that karmic sediment. And so you're stirring up the stream and you're reclaiming that. And now at this point, some new authentic expression is going to arise and come through. Now the key is to align with that, to attune that, to feel and integrate it inside. Shamans call it soul retrieval. And a new aspect of beingness comes through and creates in a new way. And it's important that we unleash that, allow that to come into being, to emerge into the world. So, coming into yourself, your true self, is then also crucial to the shift, because as you express you, you connect with the higher paradigm. What you're doing ultimately, as you come through your karma, you start to emerge into the higher dimensions. And specifically, you start to activate the spirit light body. What is that? And how does it support, assist in the shift, in our ascension? Well, there are connected through the chakras are various layers, bodily vehicles of expression. And the highest one is the spirit light body, the seventh one, at least highest in the sense of what we're generally able to connect with in this form at this time. The spirit light body is known by some as the macabre. And when you connect with it, it feels like a body of lightness. And the key is to breathe this down into your body and engage, feel into it now. We are living in two worlds, not one. There's the old paradigm, the old 3D, 1, 2, 3D paradigm around us. There's the karmic plane, and then there's this new paradigm, a new world. And the spirit light body is intimately connected with that realm, with the fifth, sixth, seventh densities. So by activating the spirit light body, we're starting to already walk within the new paradigm. Now it's important to say that paradigm is here and now all around us. It infuses the lower one at this current time. So it's not like we're waiting for the paradigm, the new paradigm to come. It's not like we're waiting to live in 5D consciousness. We must start to live it now. We must start to embrace the spirit light body, the sense of lightness, interconnectivity, where signs and synchronicity are streaming around us. That's what it means to be living in this incredible vehicle. It's like you're in this incredible flow. You're walking through life, the 3D world, but you're seeing the patterning, the interconnectivity, and you're responding to that, and you're coming from that. And because this becomes more of your reality, you create the experiences more around you in your life. And so, coming into the spirit light body and embodying it here and now is the pinnacle of what we can realize as human beings, as beings experiencing what it's like to be human and interdimensional, multidimensional. That's the pinnacle of the experience that we're able to embody here right now. And it's utterly divine, magical. Even when you're challenged, you realize the purpose of the challenge. You come to realize that. And so you don't begrudge it. You see it as an opportunity to evolve and grow, to come more into that vehicle. So the spirit light body is our vehicle of its ascension, our vehicle of the shift. And ultimately, as this vehicle falls away, whenever that timing is due for you, when this falls away, you're continuing through reality, but you're now in the 5D. You're now in the new paradigm. That's the value, the power, the joy, the miracle of embodying the spirit light body here and now.
A wonderful tribe of light bringers, light showers, way showers, mavericks that are gathering all over the planet in different type of groups. And it's such a joy to feel that it's gathering pace and they're really bringing forth the tools, the techniques, the new ways of being that will inspire millions of others within the next, I would sense, 20 years. And I'm happy to be part of it.
Finally, how will the new paradigm be realized and when? I think it's really essential to dispel a key myth, which is often expressed in the spiritual mainstream. We are not going to be ascending all together. That's not the experience of ascensions and shifts within other constellations. What tends to happen is that a body of souls, a wave, are preparing themselves, are in the right place at the right time with the right inquiry that can accelerate, integrate, attune to what is taking place all around us. And right now, it is only the minority that are in a place where they're experiencing that and embracing that and integrating the experiences It's only a relatively small minority who've begun that journey. To me, when I look around, I would say that the majority are probably thousands of years from 5D consciousness. So it's essential that you don't hold yourself back because you're waiting for everybody else to shift. That's not going to happen. We don't have to collectively raise vibration till everybody emerges in 5, 6, 7D. That's just not going to happen. That raises the question, of course, what happens to the people who don't ascend, who are not following the shift, who are not really at a place where that's a part of their reality at this time? What happens to them? Well, even though this world in the 3D will become unlivable for sophisticated life, there will be new realities in other constellations. And it's my knowing, my experience, that the angelic realm is creating, has been creating this net, if you like, all around the earth in the 4D. And so when people pass on, they are embraced within this net. They find their way into the angelic realm. They experience often traveling through a tunnel and coming into the light. That's what many people describe as they pass on. And that is coming through your karmic density, which is not yet processed, and coming into the angelic realm. And from there, a future incarnation in a place which is commensurate with your inquiry that now needs to happen. That will likely happen for the majority as they pass on, because the window of opportunity is now closing. When you look at what's taking place, we probably have just a few decades of viable 3D living of this current karmic construct in which to process all our karma and shift into 5D. If you've begun the journey, and the likelihood is if you're watching this documentary, you've already connected or you've already begun. If you've begun the journey, then you have sufficient time. You have a few decades, but you don't have any time to waste. You must embrace what is going on now. And even if you don't understand it, it doesn't matter. What matters is you go with your heartfelt feelings and you respond to the rightness of your soul. And you will see the reflections. And even if you don't get it, even if you don't fully comprehend it, then that doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Feel the integration of the sense of rightness of your soul and go with that. And everything will be revealed around you. So you don't have to understand it, but beginning the journey of embracing and embodying the soul right now is crucial. And as you do that, you're going to be walking through this world and you're going to be progressively witnessing the interdimensional interplay, the signs of synchronicity, the deeper meaning. And as the karmic construct begins to break down through storms, through breakdown in the biosphere, through earthquake and volcanic activity, shifts in the tectonic plates, as that starts to break down this reality that we're in, over time, you're progressively, increasingly attuning to the shift of energy from the old paradigm into the new. You are living, beginning to live, breathe that right now. And it's going to guide you to the right place to be. And it's going to unveil your destiny, your reason for being here. And the reason for being here is going to be expressing who you are, unleashing who you are, supporting, helping others. Yes, that's all a part of the soul. But we also need to have firm boundaries, to not get sucked into the limitation and fears of other people's reality. Stand in your truth, uncover, unfold, unveil your truth, shine the light, embody it. Embody the accuracy, the authenticity, the reality of who you are. And have the courage to step into and express that. And as you do, even though other people go into fear, they can see the resilience, the resoluteness, the commitment, the alignment in your own field. And they'll be inspired by that. And if anything's going to help them begin the shift, then that's going to help. So that more and more people can be a part of this. That would just be awesome, beautiful, wonderful to have a group of people the world over, feeling inspired by this, shifting with this incredible movement, which unleashes them as who they really are. And simultaneously, being a positive force for change, helping others see beyond their fear of limited physical reality. Humanity used to be tribal. And the one great advantage, well, there are many, but a key great advantage of social media, for example, is that people gather together in groups to share their experiences, to reflect to one another, to inquire, unfold, evolve, and grow. But we must also have physical communities. That's why the Transition Towns Network, which has sprung up around the world, is so vital, so important at this time, because we must learn to support one another locally and draw on the local resources of low impact housing, of growing food in our own locality, of acquiring energy in our own locality. Because as the system itself fractures and fragments, it's going to be important that we come together to support one another. These will be what I'm given, what I'm shown, islands in the storm, islands in the storm, where we're supporting one another, we're helping one another, we're calming the fears. This must start to happen now in this crucial part of the shift. I do believe, even though that's not fully happening now, I do believe that is going to happen more and more, and that many people around the planet are tuned in to support and help, even if they don't fully understand the full magnitude of what's taking place. I can feel that in my heart, that's beginning to accelerate now. And that's a really powerful thing that we gather to support one another. And as we do that, we're going to come into this incredible, interconnected expansion. We're going to feel our cosmic being coming through our spirit light body. We're going to feel attuned to the shift into the higher plane. You're going to feel signs and synchronicity, observe, witness, sense, intuit, happening all around you. It's like a choir of angels supporting the movement, supporting your movement. And you realize that's the purpose of being here and coming through this final transformation. That's the phase that has begun now, that we must fully embrace and embody and work into. And if we do, we're going to experience this incredible paradigm shift.
Recognizing you, something I've got to, makes me smile just to watch what you do.
Namaste.
And I know that what I see is not just happening to me. There's something in your eyes I can tell.